generally accepted auditing standards, we have very specific requirements around quality control, client acceptance, continuance decisions. Certainly, because of the uncertainty surrounding some of the legal issues as part of the due diligence, and I think Carrie had mentioned, you'd certainly want to understand if the client has legal counsel and speak to the legal counsel prior to client's acceptance to make sure that's all taken care of. The integrity of the client, I think that plays key also into another specific aspect of assurance service that is really relevant here is the whole arena of the client's internal control over its financial reporting. Ron had mentioned the cash nature of the business and how different that would be. I don't think there's a lot of, perhaps, you know, other than some casino operations and things like that, there's not a lot of assurance services anymore that have to deal with high intensity cash type businesses. So how the client controls that, their financial reporting, I think there's real questions even around some fundamental things that you'd be thinking about in an audit or even a review service of an entity like this. First of all, having to do with the inventory itself. So whatever the client has recorded for its inventory balance, we certainly would have some issues around valuation, not just, you know, the dollar amount, but is it hemp or is it cannabis? What's the quality? How do you work through all that? I guess that maybe brings a new view to inventory observations for us. But it's something that certainly would be a risk that would be specific to this industry. I think the other big financial statement issue I would be very concerned about would be around, as you know, U.S. GAAP has disclosure requirements around uncertain tax provisions in the financial statements. So, you know, clearly, as Ron and Carrie have alluded to, there are some very significant tax issues here. So those types of accruals, disclosures, and we haven't even gotten to the topic yet of all of the contingencies and commitments, legal disclosures and things like that. So, you know, if you take U.S. GAAS, generally accepted auditing standards, they can be applied to audits of these clients, but there are many specific or unique considerations, I think, that you'd get into. You know, when you step back from it, I think the other thing that you need to talk to a potential client about is whether or not you'll even be able to render an opinion on the financial statements because of an inability to obtain sufficient appropriate audit evidence to support that opinion, given some of the uncertainties and risks associated with the client itself. So those are all things I think to be thinking about. Alternatives that may be possible other than an audit, if it's acceptable to the client and would be acceptable to all involved, would be some sort of agreed upon procedures engagement that doesn't require an opinion to be rendered, but the procedures could be specifically designed to accommodate the needs of whoever the users of these financials or this information may be. And then lastly, I'd just point out, I know, as a matter of fact, I think it was maybe Monday or something like that, I saw in the local news that Nevada, these businesses that are related to the cannabis industry and how the implications to utility providers and even payroll to employees and things like that all have to be done with cash currently because the federal banks won't accept pot deposits. And I think it was in just the state government, I think, was proposing some sort of virtual coin or token that could be used to pay businesses like that, and then the state would eventually redeem the cash and work through it like that. That may solve a little bit of the cash concern if you were on the audit side, but then it opens up a whole new arena that we're working on in digital assets and cryptocurrencies and valuation issues. So I think the message is that nothing's getting more simple. Everything is complex, and this industry certainly has its issues to meet, needed to be considered. But if you step back, apply the basics and the principles, I think that these things can be addressed.
Thank you. We have two questions.